is our camp in the Forest of Dean. Really chilled out. Mike's tent. You've got a new little fire that we're going to try later on. It's my tent over there. Mike's experimenting with some fire lighting techniques on his little tin. Yeah, we literally just set up, so we're settling in. Gonna tidy it up a bit in a minute. Great spot. We saw a wild boar on the way here. I'll show you roughly like the sort of area we've seen it later on. We came from up that way through the trees. This isn't the exact clearing, but there was a clearing like this with those tall leaves, as you can see. And as we were coming down, there was this joke. I'm not exaggerating. He was a beast of a boar. Just leaps out of the leaves and sort of ran away. I'd say it was at least 2 or 3 foot tall, like the back of it. Proper beast. So yeah, we came from up that way. We parked the car up about half a mile out that way up the hill, probably a bit further. Came down through the trees into this clearing. Over in that tree line, you won't be able to see it now, but we will explore it tonight. We seen like a hidden hunting hide. Almost is over there. Like a boar hunting hide. And yeah, so we came down here and we headed to a little clearing that was a bit more concealed. We've got a bit of moonshine to test out tonight.
Down in the valley so low, hang your head over, hear the wind blow, hear the wind blow, love. Hang your head over, hear the wind blow. Roses love sunshine, violets love dew. Angels in heaven know I love you. If you don't love me, love whom you please. Put your arms round me, give my heart ease. Give my heart ease, love, give my heart ease. Put your arms round me, give my heart ease. Write me a letter, send it by mail. Send it in care of the Birmingham jail.
Want some in the cup.
Yeah.
Old Smoky Mountain Tennessee moonshine.
It's good for
32.5% alcoholic volume. Strawberry moonshine. Shake well before consumption. Try to shake it well.
Fucking hell, that's a big shot as well.
Yeah, it's pretty damn good.
Oh yeah. That's good.
Mm. It's alright, isn't it?
Yeah, kept my heart burn off though. That's why I don't really do spirit. No selling it.
We got here, left Bristol at about 11 o'clock, got here by about 12, just under. First thing when we came from the car down the hill, a big wild boar and some little ones. There's this boar that was probably about 2 or 3 foot tall, a pretty beastie boar. This is the big hammock that I've set up just for us to chill on. It's just a bit of a, it's like a free man hammock, just to mess about on. Mike's just off looking for things, scouting. But yeah, we've seen some wild boar. There's a lot of ants, big red ants. We're just by a, behind where I am now, there's a big clearing and across the way there's some sort of watchtower, like a ranger tower. Radio check. Radio check.
I hear you.
Yeah, Mike, I don't know where he's gone. He's gone that direction somewhere. But yeah, it's pretty chill. We've just cooked some food. Had a little bit of moonshine. It's the life. I'd like to thank anyone that does watch these videos. I know they're not informative or anything like that. It's just two mates having a good time going around camping out, wild camping in random places. And I have a, and we've had a few likes on the YouTube channel and the Instagram. It's good to see. So thank you if you've liked any of the channels or pages. This is the first time we've camped in the Forest of Dean. And it seems alright so far. It's Sunday now. We're going to do 2 nights. So tonight, stay here for tomorrow, do another night and leave on Tuesday. Right, just exploring the woods opposite the camp. And I found this ranger's hide. It's like a hunting. It's like a hunting position. Yeah, that's me. I just, it's pretty cool. Metal ladder going up onto a hunting platform. forest. We've seen wild boar, big giant beetles, like scarab type beetles. Loads of them gather under your tent, like in the night. You wake up in the morning and they sort of come out under your tent. Yeah, this morning, up behind me, a wild boar basically came right into our camp. It seen me, and then it looked at me, and then bolted off the other way, and it was big. It was probably like 2.5 foot from back to hoof. But yeah, it's a brilliant place. I was doing some research on it, and it was actually the Forest of Dean goes back to like sort of Saxon times, Saxon kings, and it was one of the first, it was actually the first, or the first forest in England or Britain, I guess, to be used as a royal reserve, like a royal forest, just for the king to come hunting in. And it was sort of outlawed for people, anyone who wasn't royalty, to come in here. And obviously, hundreds of years ago, they had boars and wolves, and we killed them off in this country. After a while, they became extinct. So over the last few years, people have started reintroducing them into the wild, like into Scotland, Forest of Dean. There's wolves up in certain parts of, I think there's wolves here, but I think they're in some sort of enclosure. It is a great camp. This is day two. Mike's just gone off to find some wood to make something, a bit of bushcraft. Now I'm relaxing in the camp. We've had a bit of cooking, a bit of moonshine last night, and have a bit more later. It's been a good time. Lots of ants around. They don't bite. They're big and they like crawling on you. But they don't seem to bite, luckily. It's always nice just to get out away from the city sometimes. Like, I find that when I'm out in nature, I get the most peaceful sleeps. Like, some people get, they'd be scared or paranoid sleeping out in a tent, but it's so peaceful. We've never had any trouble at all, and I've been doing it years now. Such a peaceful sleep. It'd be one of the best nights you ever had. As long as your sleeping system's all set up, like you've got a good roll mat or air bed or something, good sleeping bag, nice and cozy. Last night we didn't have any rain. It was just, it dropped, the temperature dropped a little bit, but nothing really. It was pretty warm. And then I woke up a lot earlier. I woke up about 6, Mike woke up about just gone 7, but I could hear all the boar moving through the bushes about 5 to 10 meters away from our camp.
Impatient Imogen on the text says, where's Abba? They're coming up, don't worry. That was Tygo, and imagine yours. Born to be yours.
Ooh-wee.
Now
it's the music police
with DCI Scott Mills on BBC Radio 2.
Okay, let's try and help somebody else who's got a song going round and round in their head. If I can't solve it, then it's over to you, the rest of the Radio 2 listeners, and there's millions of you, otherwise known as the music.
Yeah. to the Shiny Happy playlist, and it is fabulous.
I'm really and accelerating fast. I could do this in a second. Looking in the rear view so I can go and swell. Leaving boys behind, cause it's legal just to kill. Shift gear automatic, damned if I do. Who is gonna stop me when I'm coming through? What we got left is just me and you. But if I go to bed, baby, can I take you?
Committed suicide, didn't he?
Did he?
Terrible thing. Yeah, like an alien. But I went, when I was a kid, I went to his lab. Crinky Bottom.
Crinky Bottom?
It's where Noel Edmonds lived.
Sounds a bit weird, doesn't it?
Mr. Floppy had his own house. Everything was like,
Floppy, Floppy, Floppy. I wonder why he felt the need to have Mr. Blobby on his show.
Just a mommy alien. Yeah. Just so he could get away with touching kids.
Probably, isn't it? Was that on the BBC as well?
No, Edmund had a weird career though. He went like recluse at the end of his career, didn't he? I watched a documentary about him the other day.
Oh, fucking hell.
Like feet up the street, then your back, shift your own. When I told you involved with something like an airplane
crash, I'm not sure. He had something weird, yeah, I can't remember. It wasn't nothing like dodgy, like key and stuff or nothing, but he had something like that.
Moonshine is fucking kick your ass, don't it?
Is that quite well enough?
Probably a small animal between us. The equivalent. That's meat.
We've got about a baby's worth of meat.
Give me your baby.
Hello there. Angel from the nightmare. A shadow in the darkness of the moor. Hello there.
Proper West Country.
Hello there.
Angel from the nightmare.
The angel from the nightmare.
Unsuspecting victim
of darkness in the valley. We can be like Jack and Sally if we want.
Where you can always find me.
We don't have Halloween at Christmas,
but in the night we'll
wish this never ends.
We'll wish this never ends.
Tom DeLonge's voice means,
hello there, where are you?
Where are you?
Where are you?
Upon your person?
Well, you will have to listen to find out what happened, because I don't want to give too much away. But in your assembly this morning in Lincolnshire, I could be surprising you.
Oh my goodness, mate. I wonder how many parents, teachers, kids are now giddy with glee that you may be coming to visit them later on in the show. Okay.
Peter.
Jazzy jackets on.